Canadian wartime contributions. From the start of the war in 1939, Canadians were providing Britain with agricultural produce, wood, iron, coal, and other raw materials. But to further help in Britain's war effort, Canadians needed an industry that could produce large quantities of military-grade weapons, vehicles, aircraft, and various other war materials. A scan of available producers in Canada found them wanting, each requiring either production and building retrofits or facilities that had to be built. So money was invested, construction began, and one by one, the factories were operational, and a steady flow of machinery began. Over the course of the war, Canada shipped not only needed raw materials, but also large quantities of Canadian-made weaponry, vehicles, and other products to Britain. In September of 1939, Britain entered the war with 80,000 military vehicles of all types. However, 75,000 of those vehicles were abandoned during the evacuation at Dunkirk, France, only 8 months later. Thus, now seriously lacking in ground defenses, Britain turned to Canada, in particular, the auto industry, to replace what had been lost. By war's end, Canada had provided much more than just those replacement vehicles. Canadian industries produced over 800,000 military transport vehicles. That included 50,000 tanks, also 40,000 various big military and anti-aircraft guns, plus 1.7 million small arms. That achievement was only made possible by the numerous contributors. The steelmakers, Stelco, and Dofasco in Hamilton, Ontario, Dominion Steel Company of Sydney, Nova Scotia. National Steel Car Limited in Hamilton became a major supplier of artillery, shells, plus its military aircraft manufacturing in Malton, Ontario, in addition to the flow of various rail cars for CNR and CPR. The Bombardier Company of Valcour, Quebec built military snowmobiles. Canadian Pacific Railway built tanks in their shops in Montreal. 25-pounder Sexton self-propelled guns were built by Montreal Locomotive Works. A heavy utility vehicle body was developed in Canada, and almost 4,000 were manufactured by General Motors in Oshawa. Nearly 350 huge merchant ships were built in Canada during the war. 10,000-ton freighters, they called them. Big, slow, but reliable, these ships were designed to adapt to a large variety of cargoes. And the ships, together with their crews, provided delivery of much of Canada's war production. Some 57,000 individuals were employed in merchant shipbuilding. Another 27,000 worked in military naval shipbuilding, which included work on destroyers, frigates, corvettes, and minesweepers. Production in the aircraft industry went from almost non-existent to 4,000 military aircraft a year by the end of the war. At its peak, the industry employed 120,000 men and women, and Canada assembled a total of 16,000 military aircraft throughout the war. Another role that Britain asked of Canada was to train pilots from all over the empire under the British Commonwealth Air Training Plan. Some of these air and ground crews trained in Moncton, New Brunswick, and also in Amherst and DeBert, Nova Scotia. By the end of the war, the program, with over 150 training centers throughout Canada, had produced over 130,000 aircrew for the military of Great Britain, Australia, New Zealand, and of course, Canada. These newly trained crews included pilots, wireless operators, air gunners, and navigators. One might opt to mention two of the notable individuals that rose to the war cause, Clarence Decatur, or C.D. Howe as most Canadians remember him, was made Canadian Minister of Munitions and Supply in 1940. He then proceeded to transform the Canadian economy from its pre-war agricultural base to an industrial power, with the skills and capacity needed to manufacture the required ships, aircraft, trucks, tanks, field artillery pieces, ammunition, and arms. And also Toronto's W. Garfield Weston, who built his father's baking business across Canada and Britain and kept his British factories running, thus providing essential foodstuffs to a population which the enemy meant to starve into submission. Then, following one of the fiercest skirmishes during the Battle of Britain, which saw Britain lose 16 of their own aircraft, Garfield Weston, along with fellow Canadian Max Aiken of Minto, New Brunswick, Lord Beaverbrook, Britain's minister in charge of aircraft production, Weston pledged $445,000, a huge sum at that time, the cost of replacing the 16 lost fighter aircraft. Sacrifices and achievements for Canadians during the Second World War were many and came in all forms. Patriotic Canadians from all walks of life, French and English speaking, from the East Coast to the West of Canada, pitched in. These contributions of hardworking Canadians on the home front were essential in helping triumph in the war. The challenge was huge, but when asked, Canada definitely showed up to be counted.
So will you please say hello to the folks that I know? Tell them I won't be long. They'll be happy to know that as you saw me go, I was singing this song. We meet again, don't know when, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day.